Hi friends, Angular 18 has been released. In this video, I'm going to talk about the new features those are getting released as part of Angular 18. Without wasting time, let's get into the video. In Angular 17, new control flow syntaxes have been introduced, but these were on developer preview. In Angular 18, these become stable. Also, in version 17, a new feature, defer block, got introduced. This feature allows developers to lazy load content such as components, directives, etc. This was also in developer preview and now this becomes stable. In Angular 17, signals were introduced. Now there has been some key changes related to signals in Angular 18. Angular 18 introduces signal inputs, a mechanism for binding values from parent components to child components using signals. So far, we have used @input decorator for this. Angular 18 lays the groundwork for future versions where components will be entirely signal driven. Let me highlight this again, signals are getting more important. I have uploaded a video recently on signals. You can use that to learn signals quickly. So, components will be entirely signal driven. This means change reduction will be based on signals rather than the current zone based system. Considering that, Angular team has removed zoneJS. That means Angular is zoneless now. As zoneJS has been removed, the build size will come down. This also improves the performance. Okay, but millions of existing applications are running on top of zoneJS. So what will happen to those when we upgrade to Angular 18? Don't worry, Angular always supports backward compatibility. Apart from these, there are some minor feature changes as well. In content projection, now we have option to provide fallback content. Angular now supports TypeScript 5.4. So what are you waiting for? Try upgrading to Angular 18 and experience these features. Soon I will be posting videos on each of these new features. That's all for now. See you in my next video. Thank you. Bye.